Women make the world go round. And this month, we celebrate their achievements as we feature history makers you're already familiar with and sometimes even lesser known names you should have on your radar. Our change-making woman to inspire us today is a familiar face in social circles. She is a chemist in designer clothes, an animal lover, a mother, a cancer warrior, and a philanthropist. Pinky Tobiano, happy Women's Month, and thank you for joining us in the studio.
Thank you for having me, Michelle. I'm so thankful and so happy to be here.
All right. I want to open with Pasok Buenas.
Pasok this is your, Buenas, yes.
Why don't you tell us about this Pasok Buenas? This is your signature mantra.
Yes. I believe in manifestation, manifesting positivity to people around you. When you manifest success, it goes naturally. So Pasok Buenas.
So you do this with your staff? You do this with family and friends?
Yes. Every Monday, the whole company, nationwide, my team, we say Pasok Buenas. And it's really effective. Sales come in, positivity come in, and it's happy. It's like releasing happy endorphins, manifesting success to everyone.
All right. Now, you mentioned about your company. So let's start with Pinky Tobiano by the numbers. How many businesses do you own currently, and how many did you found?
Well, currently, I'm the CEO of two companies, and recently, I just had a joint venture with one of the biggest French testing lab in the world called Bureau Veritas.
For your Qualibet.
For my Qualibet, perfectly said, yes.
Okay, so you have Progressive Laboratories.
And KPP Qualibet. Powers.
KPP Powers and Qualibet. All right, and how big is the workforce for all of your companies?
Well, the workforce is around 400, 500. Wow. Yes, and I'm very proud to say we're 100% Filipino-owned. I started this business when I was 21 years old.
Wow. How did you get into, you're a chemist by training. Progressive Laboratories, for those who are not too familiar, this is a toll manufacturer for veterinary
products.
Medicines.
Yes. Products. So Progressive is a toll manufacturing for veterinary. Ever since I was small, I worked in the poultry supply of my parents. I would sell animal medicines. I said, someday I would make the best animal medicine. So I wanted to be a chemist. So serendipitously, I was able to make my lab and making the best animal medicines, not only locally, and it's now being exported. I make for the biggest brands in the country, and I'm very happy every time I see my brand on TV, shelves abroad. It makes me very proud that the Filipino can and will shine globally.
And it's a woman chemist.
It's a woman, yes. Normally, chemists globally, internationally, you know, are men. Mm-hmm. Antoine Lavoisier, Aristotle. So now a woman chemist is on the shelf.
That's good. I know that you always say you don't just leave a signature, you leave an autograph.
Yes.
You do it with flair.
You do it with pride and dignity mm-hmm. and gratitude.
Speaking of being in the veterinary medicine industry, of course, one of the big issues recently for your industry is ASF vaccines.
Yes.
Where are we on that?
Okay, I guess it's so timely I met you. So ASF vaccine, ASF is the biggest problem now of the country for livestock. It compromises almost 90 billion losses for the past 2 years. There's no swine anymore. The backyard farmers who would save up OFWs would send money in. There's no pigs. So now the ASF vaccine, which KP Powers have, we are now in the application of our FDA.
Okay.
And hopefully, by God's grace, we can get it out with the support of everyone else, support of the administration, support of the regulatory people. We can make a difference. And with your help, I hope the FDA can help and support us.
But right now, just to clarify, all over the world, this is still in a trial mode.
No, all over the world. In Vietnam, it's already being used.
With proven numbers.
In Vietnam, yes,
okay.
With the proven numbers. In the Philippines, we have finished our trial, and we have worked with the Bureau of Animal Industry. Mm-hmm. The trial was very good, and
What's the success rate? What are the findings?
The success rate is around 92%, which is very good, because if you have ASF, it's 50-50. Either your pigs die or it lives. So at least with a 92% probability, it's very good for entrepreneurs, for SMEs, for small farms. Mm-hmm. And the vaccine also gives credibility to lenders like the bank, like agri loans now. So like Land Bank and DBP will have more confidence because the vaccine will lower the risk factor of lending.
So you're hoping that this gets the FDA approval within the year? Is that reasonable?
I hope within the quarter, because these vaccine, we have tried it for almost 17 months. It's not just today. I went inside the farm last year, so it's already 17 months, and I think it's about time the Philippines have the hope. And I'm appealing humbly to the FDA to help us. Right. We're now submitting all the additional documents within the week. Trials have already been concluded, and all the participating trial farms swear by the vaccine. It really helps. It creates a difference, and the confidence and security of 92%, it will truly increase revenues of the country.
All right. So changing your hat from the chemist hat to social media influencer hat. By the numbers again, how many followers do you have on Instagram?
Well, on Instagram, I'm stronger. I have around 4.4 million followers. Mm-hmm. And it started during pandemic.
Like most of the social media influencers. And how many hours of your day do you usually document?
Well, I document randomly things I like, things I enjoy. And it's so funny, people find it sometimes I'll just post, I don't even edit. Well, it depends on my mood and what I want to share. But most of my posts are very inspirational, uplifting, and I want to spread happy vibes to everyone.
Happy vibes. What has social media taught you?
Social media have taught me to be very relevant. Social media allowed me to create a change, especially to those people in need. I have a program called Grateful Tuesday. In fact, my friend Cornerstone Entertainment and Mac Merla has helped me. Through social media, during the pandemic, I was able to help almost 300,000 families affected by the pandemic and the typhoon.
How did you do it?
Well, the program Social Grateful Tuesday online, I would go to the streets and help people see it, and they help. Social media can help create positive impact. So I saw the power of social media transforming lives.
Does it also scare you though? I mean, on social media, everyone has a big microphone and they can just bash you and criticize you.
Yes.
Even without understanding the whole picture.
Yes, it does. When I was doing my Grateful Tuesday, a lot of people thought I will be running for politics. Well, you don't need to run for politics to create a positive change in the lives of the people around you. So it's true. Social media is a big platform. It scares me sometimes. I have to be very mindful. One thing I don't post is most about my family, which they're very private. If I post my husband, he really don't like it. But I like to share women, especially survivors like me, once a single mom. There's hope at the end of the tunnel. And life is beautiful, but it's your mindset.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned survivor.
Yes.
I know that you are a cancer survivor.
Yes.
And I know the story of you fighting cancer alongside your mom.
Yes.
How did that experience change you?
Wow, fighting with my mom was a very...
Both of you had it at the same time.
Every time I reminisce, it's really emotional. It was very difficult because every time we would go chemo or go to the hospital, my children will really tear up. They don't know every time I walk the door, will mommy still come home? It's a very painful phase of my life, mm-hmm. seeing my kids suffering and people that you love in fear. Mm-hmm. So, but we are now declared cancer-free.
So what do you want to tell the other people experiencing health issues?
Well, people experiencing health issues, you have to address it early. Early detection is very important. And find your support group. Don't wallow in negativity. God will never give us a trial we can't handle because we have a bigger God. There's no problem big because He is in control.
Mm-hmm. And there is life after
yes.
these challenges. And
yes.
now I know that you spend a lot of time globetrotting,
yes.
traveling, attending fashion shows. So for your next Pinky by the Numbers, how many countries have you visited?
Well, I don't keep track of the numbers I visit, but I'm so excited to spend Holy Week with my friends. We're going to Bangkok. After, I'm going to Marinduque with a good friend too. I like to spend more time now discovering the beauty of our Philippines. I'd like to show the world that the Philippines is a beautiful place to discover, to attract more tourists to visit our country.
You know, when people mention your name, they always say you're one of the most influential. You're always in the influential list. You're always around powerful, influential people as well, whether it's an artist like Moira de la Torre or another celebrity or powerful politicians from Malacañang or, you know, LGUs. Do you wonder, would you say that your greatest gift is the gift of being able to connect?
Yes, and being able to connect is not a gift of everyone. I like connecting good people together because I believe in the power of synergy. And with good synergy, you create positive impact of the lives of the people around you. And I like giving back because I always tell people, it's nice to have a grateful heart. So I connect people to people in need, and it comes back to you a thousandfolds.
And Pinky, of course, you're still young. What is your next act?
Well, my daughter's getting married in 2 weeks, and I'm very excited. I'm very happy for her.
A new chapter.
And a new chapter in my life, and it's so happy. If I can just put my children in a capsule, giving them everything I can. I raised them single-handedly, a single mom. Now it's a new chapter of my daughter's life. I can never imagine the happiness I have now deep inside my heart. And I wish her the best life can offer.
Final question. Since you mentioned your daughter, what is the greatest lesson you learned from your mom and the greatest lesson you're going to teach your daughter and maybe your granddaughter one day?
Hard work. I learned the value of hard work from my parents, and had it not been for them, I wouldn't be seated in front of you sharing my life journey, my struggles, and my success.
Hard work. On that note, Pinky, thank you so much for joining us and painting the studio pink this morning. It was very inspiring to speak with you, and happy Women's Month.
Thank you so much, Michelle, and happy Women's Month too.
All right.